हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कामत एस्ट्रोलॉजी। एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्पीक ऑन वन मोर टॉपिक, दैट इज अंडरस्टैंडिंग द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ पर्सन हु इज बॉर्न इन द पूर्व भाद्रपदा नक्षत्र। सो लेट अस बिगिन बाय अंडरस्टैंडिंग अ फ्यू थिंग्स अबाउट द पूर्व भाद्रपदा नक्षत्र। The Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra is the 25th Nakshatra out of the 27 Nakshatras in the natural zodiac. It is also called Purva Bhadrapada, Purva Bhadra, etc. Okay? And this Nakshatra is a part of two zodiac signs, that is Kumbh or Aquarius and Meen. So only the last Pada lies in the sign of Meen. So now look at this diagram. Okay, you can see two purple lines. One purple line is starting at 20 degrees within the sign of Kumbh. Okay, this indicates the start of Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra, and the Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra ends at the other purple line inside the sign of Meen, that is at 3 degrees 20 minutes in the sign of Meen. So this is the boundary of Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra. Now, if at the time of your birth, okay, the moon was placed between these two purple lines, then your Janma Nakshatra is nothing but Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra. So, you can see that Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra partly falls in the Kumbh Rashi, a major portion of that lies in Kumbh Rashi, and a very small portion, that is the last portion or Pada, lies in the Meen Rashi. Okay, now Kumbh Rashi is owned by Shani or Saturn, and Meen Rashi is owned by Jupiter. Okay, Jupiter is also the ruling graha of Purva Bhadrapada Nakshatra. Alright, so people born in this Nakshatra, they are influenced both by Jupiter or Guru as well as by Shani or Saturn. Now, let us understand who is the ruling deity of this nakshatra. Okay, the ruling deity of this nakshatra is a serpent called Aja Ekapada. Okay, which means it is a serpent which stands on one foot as shown in the diagram. Ekapada means one foot. So, this one-footedness actually represents a fixed view. Okay, so these people have a very fixed view of things. They are very stubborn. Okay, so once they decide something, they do not change their opinion. So the first impression is like the last impression for people born in this nakshatra. And this Aja Ekapada is also a very fierce serpent. Okay, so this nakshatra is an Ugra nakshatra or a fierce nakshatra. So people born in this nakshatra, they have three characteristics: the characteristics of Shani, the characteristics of the ruling graha Jupiter, as well as the characteristics of the ruling deity Aja Ekapada. Now, let us understand the symbol of this nakshatra. This nakshatra is represented by a two-faced person. Okay? One who looks in two directions. Okay? What this means is, the people born in this nakshatra, they have dual characteristics. Sometimes they can be extremely cruel, extremely wicked. So some of the worst thieves, dacoits, murderers, they come under this category. Okay. At the same time, they have a other face. Okay. They are also very kind. They are also very generous. But they will give away donations and money only once they are convinced about the true sincerity of the person in front of them. That is, the person in front of them is actually needy. Only then will they donate their money. Now, a major portion of this nakshatra, okay, lies inside the Kumbh Rashi. Now, Kumbh Rashi is ruled by Shani. Okay, and the ruling planet for this nakshatra is Jupiter. Now, what is Kumbh Rashi all about? Kumbh Rashi is all about research. Okay, it is the natural 11th house in the zodiac. So it is about gains through friends, through social networks, etc. Okay, so people born in the first three padas of Purva Bhadra Nakshatra, which lies in Kumbh Rashi, are extremely research oriented. Okay, they have a very good analytical thinking ability. All right, and they do good in fields involving research, involving analysis, etc. Now, people born in these three padas, which lies within the Kumbh Rashi, they experience a lot of hardships in life. Mostly, they do not get the love of their mother. Okay, this does not mean their mother dies at a young age. It means their mother may be working and she may not be able to devote much time to these people. Okay, so they are deprived of motherly love in their early ages. Second thing is, Shani gives them a lot of experiences. Okay, and Jupiter represents the higher wisdom that you gain through these experiences. Alright, so they are very practical, they are research oriented, and they are pioneers in their field. So they are very intelligent. Basically, those who are born in the first three padas of this Purvabhadra nakshatra, they have a lot of good research ability. And they get a lot of practical experiences in life through the hardships given by Shani. And they learn through the wisdom given by Jupiter from these experiences. And this is also the very reason why they don't trust anyone immediately. They don't take anyone at face value. Okay, they do their own research first and then they make a judgment. Now, the last pada, that is 3 degrees 20 minutes portion of Purvabhadra nakshatra, the ending portion, that lies entirely in the Meen Rashi. Okay, Meen Rashi is owned by Jupiter. Jupiter is also the ruler of this nakshatra. The only problem with people born in the last pada of Purvabhadra pada nakshatra is that they are very selfish. See, this represents a two-faced person. Okay, so they constantly look backward. They have a tendency to blame others for their problems. These people are God-fearing, but they tend to blame others for their problems. Okay, because they tend to look into the past. They tend to look backwards. And this is an issue if you are born in the last pada of Purvabhadrapada nakshatra. Shani is usually better in the first three padas of Purvabhadrapada nakshatra because Kumbh Rashi is the sign that represents research, that represents knowledge, that represents social network. Okay, but in the last pada, which lies in the Meen Rashi sign, okay, it is entirely ruled by Jupiter, and these people have a tendency to look back and blame others for their problems. Okay, they are very idealistic, so they do not accept the practical things that happen in life. They do not face facts. So friends, this was my analysis of people born in the Purvabhadrapada nakshatra. If you like this video, please mark it as liked on YouTube. You can subscribe to my channel Kamath Astrology by hitting the subscribe button. For any queries, feel free to write to me at astrosevaworld@yahoo.com. You can also visit my website astroseva.tripod.com or download our application Kamath Astrology from Google Play Store to get in touch with us. So guys, thanks a lot. Hope you enjoyed this video. Enjoy your weekend. Take care. Bye.